Thank you. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 7455 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to today's business. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm moved.
Thank you. I call on Sandesh Gulhani to speak to and move amendment 7455.2.
Presiding Officer, today we saw the worst ever 8 and 12 hour wait in A&E. And in the week ending 18th of December 2022, we saw the worst ever four-hour waits. The average number of beds occupied per day due to delayed discharges is also at a record high. Almost every indicator of NHS Scotland's performance has worsened, some to their worst ever level. Hundreds of thousands of Scots are waiting for treatment. This is a national emergency. People are dying unnecessarily. NHS staff are burning out, going above and beyond, but they cannot cope. The crisis in our NHS should be the priority for this Parliament because it is a priority for the people. In the Cabinet Secretary for Health's own words, this was always going to be the hardest winter the NHS has ever seen. Yet, with the rhetoric came no action. I have been warning of how bad this winter is going to get, and yet there was no prioritisation by this government to allocate time to a proper debate in Parliament prior to recess. Today, we have a ministerial statement on the NHS being slotted into the parliamentary business timetable at short notice, with not enough time allocated and not enough opportunity to scrutiny by members. The decision to slot this in came at very short notice. What has the Scottish Government given priority to in the midst of the NHS crisis? The first Scottish parliamentary debate of 2023 is not about our treasured NHS, but about Scottish independence. This is a disgrace. It is not the priority of the people of Scotland and not a good use of parliamentary time. I therefore bring forward an amendment to scrap this divisive debate and extend the time allocated to the ministerial statement on NHS winter pressures by 40 minutes to allow members to raise their concerns of their constituents and hold the Cabinet Secretary to account on his failing NHS recovery plan. We will also support and welcome a full debate as Labour's amendment requests. Remember, for those voting against these amendments, you are voting to prioritise independence over Scottish people dying unnecessarily. First Minister, the SNP don't seem to care. What we're hearing there is they're not caring. I move the amendment in my name.
Thank you. I call on Neil Bibby to speak to and move amendment 7455.1.
Presiding Officer, today the number of patients waiting more than 12 hours in emergency departments has hit its highest ever level. The head of the Doctors' Union said that the weekend Scotland's hospitals are not safe for patients. And in a few weeks, nurses will be forced to walk out of hospitals because the Scottish Government is more interested in clapping them than paying them. We are in the midst of a full-blown crisis which is threatening patient safety and putting people in unbearable circumstances. So when the people of Scotland look to their Parliament for a response this afternoon, what will they see? Another debate on a referendum, another exercise in internal party management, another excursion in creative avoidance from the real problems Scotland faces. This Parliament should reflect the people's priorities, not just the governing parties. It is welcome that the Government have finally now agreed to a statement on the NHS, but there should also be a full debate on the NHS crisis too. We moved a business motion to hold an NHS debate before Christmas instead of the SNP's proposed debate on their general election strategy, and we will do so again today. I therefore move the amendment to the business motion in my name.
Thank you. I call on George Adam to respond on behalf of the Parliamentary
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and can I wish everyone in the Chamber a Happy New Year. With that said, Presiding Officer, I'll have to move on to something with Mr Gulhani, in so much as that I will take no lectures for a member of the Conservative Party about who is caring and who is not, when he represents a political party who has proven not to be caring of the people of Scotland over the years. And it is bizarre. It is bizarre, Presiding Officer, that when the opposition asked for a statement on health at the, before the new year, towards the end of last year, I said I would bring that back to us, and I have made sure that it is the very first thing that we discuss, because the NHS is and will continue to be a priority of this government all the time. However, Presiding Officer, I'm only too happy to talk about the benefits of independence. As I've said before recess, I won't ever apologise for encouraging this Parliament to debate the people of Scotland's right to choose their own future. Hear, hear. Indeed, it's somewhat ironic that the Tories are seeking to deny a democratic debate, which will highlight how the current constitutional settlement is denying democracy in Scotland. And frankly, the cases for the people of Scotland to be given the choice and the chance of a better future is becoming stronger every day. Let me remind you of what I said towards the end of last year. We are living in a country led by the Conservatives in Westminster, with inflation running at 10%. Household incomes predicted to fall to 2014 levels. The economy is in recession. People facing the horrific choice of choosing between heating and eating this winter. Millions facing eye-watering increases in their household costs in 2023. And of course, there's Brexit compounding all, creating labour shortages, trade barriers, higher business costs and lost tax income. No wonder, Presiding Officer, the Tories don't want this Parliament debating and agreeing that this is the time for the people of Scotland to choose independence and a future that we have the opportunity to create and make our own decisions, allowing this Parliament to be able to provide that better future for Scotland. I am more surprised that Labour, seeking to obstruct this debate, we have worked well over the past 3 or 4 months, and I would have thought that Labour would have been interested in debating Anna Star Wars' 6 pledges for reform in Holyrood, which include the view, which, Presiding Officer, I share, by the way, that the Scottish people are sovereign and have the right to determine the best form of government suited to our needs. In closing, Presiding Officer, Britain, in my opinion, is broken beyond repair, and now it's time for the people of Scotland to decide their future.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 7455.2 in the name of Sandesh Gulhani, which seeks to amend Business Motion 7455 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to today's business, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote, and there will be a brief suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.